it's your mate Fred here from another scary children's story. Vampire in a Taxi. It was the first thing, my first night driving a taxi. It was night late, and there was a lot of people on the street. I was about to go home when I was held by a man in a dark street. He wore dark coat, collars up. His hat was pulled low over his eyes. If he didn't want anyone to see his face. He got into the back of my cab. I pulled off and started driving down the street. I passed him in the back, looked forward, and tracked me on the shoulder. I screamed, almost lost control of the cab. It hit a bus, drove up on the curb, and stopped just inches from a large pale glass window. I didn't know why. Well, I guess he spooked me. His touch was so cold, he smelled real bad. Just like something decaying, like a bad animal. For a few moments, everything was silent in the cab, then still shaking. I said, "Oh, sorry, but you scared the daylights out of me." I stared at him in the rear of my window. His head was silhouetted against the dark black window. I didn't see his eyes, just about shadowy shape where his face should be. I actually apologised, saying he didn't realise the tap of his shoulder could be so scary. "No, no," I said, "not my fault. My first day driving a taxi. For over 25 years I've driven a hearse." "Where was it you wanted to go?" The man in the back said, "North Cemetery." I drove in there in silence. When we got there, got out the back of the cab and told me to wait. "If you don't wait, you'll be sorry," he said. Well, I didn't feel very comfortable. I wanted the money, so I waited. After a while, we came back, and strange as it sounds, he seemed to be wiping something from his hands. He slouched down in the shadows of my back seat, and the man just said, "South Cemetery." As we drove, and when we got there, same thing happened again. He told me to wait for a minute for him. I was feeling more and more uncomfortable. I waited and wondered what he could be doing in the cemetery so late at night. What business was he putting out here? He turned to the car, brushing something from his clothes. Didn't ask any questions. He turned to the darkness in the back seat, and it seemed to be wiping something from his mouth. When he was done, he said, "He's cemetery." I'm very frightened. I determined to get my money. But of course, the lucidity began to get better of me. The smart more fears, I determined to see what he was doing. So this time, I followed him into the dark cemetery. I tiptoed behind him, stepping softly along the long grass and muck. I watched him as he walked silently along the among the headstones, seemed to be looking for one in particular. He came to a fresh grave and knelt, felt his knees, and used his hands to scrape the dirty earth until he got down to the coffin. I could barely breathe. Him, afraid he could hear me. I was terrified. I couldn't wave. My legs felt like dead weight, so I moved me to the spot. I saw him open the coffin lid and bent over the coffin. I seen see inside it. I caught a glimpse of such features of a fresh corpse lying in the open coffin. I was so terrified I couldn't see him, couldn't move in the darkness. Then the man stood up. Perhaps he heard me breathing. Maybe he heard the gravel crunch underneath my shoes. He came straight towards me, quickly, almost running, but it didn't seem like running. It was as if he was gliding fast and silent over the grass. In seconds, he came upon me, glancing at my shirt, and pulling my face close to his. I smelled his terrible, clean breath. I saw something dark and sticky dripping from his mouth. A man in it was a stammer. "A vampire?" "Yes," he screamed as he sank his fangs into my neck. The end.